Hey everybody, welcome to Singing the Scriptures. I am ready to help you if you are struggling with sleep, if you are struggling with fear at night, if you're struggling with having peace of mind. So tonight's live is going to be for everybody out there that needs help sleeping. So make sure you save this video because you want to go back and watch it. I believe that God is going to heal people tonight who have struggled for so long with insomnia. And so I'm excited. Hello, everybody that's jumping on. I'm so happy that you are here. And if this is your very first time watching, tell me this is your first time. And everybody that's on, tell me where you guys are watching from. I want to greet you before we get started. This won't be a long video, but I'm going to get right to it. Yeah, Tasha says that she's had insomnia. Okay. So I have a few scriptures from the Bible that I wrote down. Not a specific scripture, it's just various ones that I believe that the Lord is going to use to just speak to your spirit. And you know, I don't think that many times that pastors and leaders touch on this particular subject, but God gave this to me to give to you, and I believe that He wants to give you freedom in your sleep, because many of you have been bound up for many, many years. We just thank you, Jesus. Oh, you love my voice. Thank you, Charlene. And we just thank you, Jesus, that you're here already. So while everybody is jumping on and getting all comfortable, can you share the video, please? And I really, really, really love and feel encouraged when I get little hearts and thumbs up. And sometimes people put shocked faces and laughing faces. Actually, all the faces. Doesn't matter which ones, because even people that don't like my videos and they put up those little mad faces or whatnot, all they're doing is actually helping to circulate the video more. That's what it actually does. It helps to circulate the video. So that's a tip for all of you that do your own Facebook lives. The hearts and the thumbs up matter. So we bless the Lord, and we praise His holy name, 'cause He's a good, good, good Father. He's been such a good, good, good Father. There shall be peace tonight. There shall be peace tonight. Hello. I say to you, there shall be peace tonight. And sweet sleep for you. You shall rest in the Lord. Like a baby, or a malaria, you shall sleep like a baby. So thank you, Father, that tonight, God, that you are going to just impart to your people such an amazing revelation of your perfect love. And Father, we know that the word says that perfect love casts out all fear, for fear is torment, and it is not of God. So we just thank you for what you're going to do tonight. Hello, everybody. I see you. Harvest Camp Trinity, I see you. North Carolina. I wanted to read from 1 Samuel 16, a few verses. verses that I wrote down. And verse 14 says, "And now the Spirit of the Lord had departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord tormented him." Verse 17, "And Saul said to his attendants, 'Find someone who plays well and bring him to me.'" Verse 23 says, "And whenever the evil spirit from God came on Saul, David would take his lyre and he would play. And then relief would come to Saul and he would feel better. And the evil spirit would leave him. It would depart from him." Let me play over you tonight. Let the Holy Spirit play over you tonight. God, use me as a vessel. God, use me as your vessel. You're going through. There's a healing river flowing now. There is healing oil being poured out. There's a healing river flowing now. There is to the Lord. You can't hold it anymore. Your grip is so tight. Release it now. It's gonna be alright. 'Cause he's a good, good father. And he's healing you right now. Some of you have gone through so much trauma, so much trauma, that you feel like you can't get any rest, feel like you can't get any sleep, you feel like it's taking over your mind and your heart. But God says there's a healing flowing now. heal your heart. Let them go deep down. Oh. He's the God that restores. Proverbs 3:24 says that when you lie down, you will not be afraid. When you lie down, your sleep is going to be sweet. When you lie down, you will not be afraid. When you lie down, your sleep will be sweet. When you lie down, God is with you. Yes, and that's Him singing over you. A song of deliverance. Peace, peace, wonderful peace. Peace, peace, wonderful peace. I say peace, peace, wonderful peace. Coming down from the Father, the Father above. Peace, peace, wonderful peace. Peace, peace, wonderful peace over you tonight. Peace, peace, wonderful peace. Coming down from the Father up above. Do not be afraid anymore. I'm with you. Do not fear the unknown. I'm with you. Do not worry about your past. I'm with you. Lie down and sleep. Breathe in heaven. On this a little bit, but I believe that trauma comes in and it disrupts people's sleep, and I believe it's a plan of the enemy to cause you to be weary, cause you not to be rested. And so when you're not rested and he comes and attacks you, you're not suited up for the battle properly. And so I believe in this hour the Lord wants to restore peace to His people. And I believe that there will be a lot of people that will watch this video that aren't even believers, and they will come to know Jesus because they will feel the peace of God tonight. Be anxious for nothing. Be anxious for nothing. Hannah cast a leaf. Yeah.
anxious for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and petition, everything, by prayer and petition and thanksgiving, present your request to God. That's what the word says. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, it'll guard your heart. Let him guard your mind.
So the Lord's not going to let me go with that one. He's not going to leave it alone. So I just feel the Lord saying that there's somebody on here that you've gone through like a divorce. And before the divorce, or a fractured relationship or something, but I really feel it's divorce. You didn't have that much trouble in your sleep every now and then. But once the divorce happened, it's like you can't get any sleep. Just toss and turn, and you replay this movie of your mistakes over and over and over, and you let this torment happen. It's what it is. It's torment. Oh, I see your comment, Beck. Jesus' name. And so I believe that God wants to heal you tonight. Do you believe that? He wants to heal you tonight. So that no matter what happened, his peace is just going to wash over you. Sora mani, rishta na la cruz de kitidia. I saw your comment, Ruby. Andara basura kitidia andara basura.
You will dream again. Depression is lifting. Depression is lifting. You won't need medication, but the Lord is gonna rock you to sleep. Just climb up in His arms and dream again. Let Him restore hope and dream again. Yes, you'll wake up rested and renewed. You'll wake up rested. Promise to us, and He will never lie. That's His promise to us. Psalms 127 verse 2 says, for He gives to His beloved sleep. For He gives to His beloved
His glory.
and to proclaim the name of Jesus. He's a good, good Father, and He will never leave you alone. He's a good, good Father, and He's right there holding your hand. God, open up their eyes, let them see you standing right there by them. Open up their eyes, let them see the angels that stand guard. Let them see the mighty camp around those that love you. That's why I'm gonna lay down in peace. That's why I'm gonna wake up rested. That's why I'm gonna lay down and sleep. That's why I'm gonna wake up refreshed. You're a good, good Father. So ramandiriya. You're a good, good Father. And I thank you, Jesus. And if you're beating yourself up over mistakes, just stop that right now. Stop doing that. I heard this like rehearsing. You were just rehearsing things over and over, just upset with yourself, and even made your heart rate go up, and it made you almost have like a panic attack. You're super hard on yourself. And so we break off condemnation right now in the name of Jesus, and we break off that root of rejection. Walk in liberty, God says, be free, come walk in His liberty. You will lie down in green pastures, lie down in green pastures, He leads you beside still waters, He leads you beside. Forgive yourself, you know, and just let that go, because you can't punish yourself. I know you feel like you messed up, so you feel like you need to be punished. You just break that off of you right now. You know, God said that anyone that calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved, and so He wants to give you new mercies every day, and so you ask the Lord to forgive you and just let it go. Remember it? Why do you keep bringing it up? Just let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Into the hands of the Lord, let it go, let it go. A prayer request, go ahead and place that down, because I said that I would pray for people, and I want to hold to that. Thank you guys for joining me tonight. Let's pray. And if you're watching the replay, I go back and I pray over the things that I see that people put down. If you message me, I do the same there. I pray. Me and my husband, we pray. We believe in the power of prayer. And so, finally, brethren, be strong in His might. just pray over you right now. And I just decree and declare the freedom of the Lord over your mind. And I command every chain to be broken off of you, off of your spirit. And I command the wounded places to be healed in the name of Jesus. Sora manda rica rara soria tatatiara basu. And just continue to play worship music as you go to sleep. Turn everything off. We just need to turn everything off for just a moment. Let it all go. I love social media. Sometimes I just have to turn it off. And I have to hear just the voice of the Lord. Somebody put that there on, or someone had cancer or has cancer. So we just pray right now in the name of Jesus. And God, that you would touch her. And Jesus heals cancer. And cancer is not bigger than the name of Jesus. So we just declare healing. And Holly, for your son to be free from drugs, every addiction, every spirit of witchcraft, we break its hold over his life, over his mind, and over his calling in the name of Jesus. Whoever just wrote that they feel alone, in the name of Jesus, I pray that there will be a revelation of the Father's love in your heart right now, that you would never feel alone ever again in your entire life. For you will always know that God is with you. And if God be for you, who can be against you? In the name of Jesus, we pray for Liz, for emotional healing. Walter, in the name of Jesus, I break off that spirit of fear. I break off hallucinations that are brought on by the enemy. I'm just going to minister to Walter real quick, guys, so you may have to put your request in, because I follow the leading of the Lord. So Walter, you're on here, okay? And you guys begin to pray. You see hooded whatever beings. Can I tell you something that helped me and freed me? You know, the enemy is a liar. He is a liar, and there is no truth in him. And so what he does is he creates these visions and these illusions that are not true. They're completely false, so that we fear them. You know, I used to think that the devil was this humongous creature. He was huge, and he was strong, and he was so scary looking. And then one day the Lord showed me the enemy. A little chicken, just like a little tiny chicken, just pecking at my feet, just being so annoying. And I know that may sound silly to some of you, but that helped me get free so much, because when he would come and bring these hallucinations, I would immediately look down on the floor and I would say, get out in the name of Jesus. That I knew that everything that he was bringing me was to torment my mind. And I used to live in fear a lot. I would look all through the house, all in the closets. The lights had to be on. No, it's not freezing, dear. That's your Wi-Fi. And the Lord freed me from that. And so I don't fear. I just walk in peace and love. And if the enemy tries to bring something, I literally just laugh. Say, it ain't gonna happen. You gotta go in the name of Jesus. Get out. You're not allowed here. You're trespassing. This is holy ground. So get out in the name of Jesus. And the enemy knows that if he messes with me too much, it'll just push me into deep intercession. And I'll just go for hours and pray. So if that's what we're gonna do, we're gonna do it. Yeah, you can relate. So go ahead and put your prayer requests. So demons have to flee your house, and you need to stand up and you need to tell the devil, say, in the name of Jesus Christ, get out now. Anoint your house and pray over it. Put oil. And just symbolically, just open the door. Like they did in that movie, The War Room. Just open the door and it's out. And all that fear is being replaced with the love of the Father. Thank you, Lady Ty, for saying that. We just plead and we just declare the love of the Father over you. The love of the Father over you in Jesus' name. Hey, Prophet Coleman. The love of the Father over you. And I just pray for your torn rotator cuff in in the name of Jesus, you said you had severe back and knee pain. I just speak right now the alignment of Jesus Christ. New knees and new back in Jesus' name. On your page when you share, you know, not just my videos, but just things that really speak to people's heart. You guys are ministers when you do that. You're ministering to people, and people write me all the time and they'll say, I don't even know how I found your video. Somebody shared it and I can't even remember. I remember Nicole said she didn't even remember how she found the videos, but somebody shared it. And you know, God's using this to reach so many people. He's using this to reach the lost. And I'm so thankful for him, because without him, we can't do anything, guys. There is no ministry without Jesus. There is nothing without Jesus. There is no worship without Jesus. So I'm just so thankful that he would use us. He would say, I'm going to use that one right there. I'm going to use that one right there. And I'm going to let my glory be seen on my people. And when they humble themselves before me, I'm going to lift them up. Because I'm a good father. And I want good things for them. And they can't even imagine. Scratch the surface of what I prepared for them. They love me. Yeah, so I'm so thankful. Are you guys thankful that God would use you? And if you just reach one person, if you just reach one person in your family, one person at the grocery store, one child, one family member, one stranger, you know, the Lord is so pleased with that. Who you're talking to. You don't know what people are going through. There's a lot of people out there that need to know that there's hope. I was praying earlier, and I see your comment, Brenda, and I'm going to pray. I was praying earlier, and again, I saw two visions, and I saw one vision was of heaven. Man, this blew my mind, guys. You know, in the Bible in Revelation, it talks about the sea of glass. Well, from the sea of glass, I saw this huge white piano on top of the sea of glass. Yes, no more suicide in Jesus' name. And it was a woman playing the piano, and behind her on the land were millions of people just standing in front of the sea of glass. Of course, is the throne of God. And this woman began to play. And when she began to play, everything in heaven stopped and looked. It was amazing. It was a white, just beautiful, huge piano on top of the sea of glass. And she got to this point, and the music began to build, and the people began to go crazy. When I tell you they begin to go crazy, they begin to go nuts. Like they were banging and jumping and falling on the ground and jumping and screaming praises like I've never seen. And people were laying out and people were jumping. I mean, can you imagine millions and millions of people? And Jesus was sitting there and he was just looking. And this woman was just playing this piano. One day, we're not just going to be singing, looking up into the sky. We're going to be looking right at Jesus. And we're going to be saying, you are holy. Was just, I saw I want to say it was like high school teenagers. There was a lot of them. It was like they were in a cafeteria, and I could see them all, the different cliques. You know how high school is, and all the different groups. And I could just feel like just hurt and suicide and a loss of identity. People just pretending to be something that they weren't, and it just looked like chaos, and my heart just began to break. And I thought, God, there's so many people out there. So I just say, God, would you just send me? And if you have to send me through Facebook, Father, just let the wind of God be on it. Go everywhere, that people would come to know you. I sing the scriptures, but I'm not anything special. It's all the Lord. You know, it's all the Lord. Without him, we can do nothing. And so I just pray right now for everybody that tuned in. Yeah, I pray for the teens in the schools. There's so many people that need Jesus. So would you do me a favor this week? Share Jesus with somebody, whether it's on your page or face to face, or write a note to your mailman and just say Jesus loves you. Like, I don't know, there's so many ways, but I'm gonna end the video. And for all of you that don't know me, my name is Jenny Weaver. I'm a mom, I'm a wife, I'm a worshiper, I'm a psalmist, and you can follow me on all social media outlets at Jenny Weaver Worship. Follow me everywhere, and you can also get my brand new EP CD called Run With The Horses. You can download that from all the places, from everywhere, anywhere that you can think of where they would have music, you can get it. And if you want one of those hard copies, because you're in my age or older, because it seems like my age we like hard copies of CDs, then you can go to my website, which is www.jennyweaverworships.com. click on the shop and get it from there. And I will sign it, whatever name you put at the shipping address, I will sign it that name, and I will send it out to you. And a lot of you can see this wonderful little shirt that I'm wearing. It says, "Nobody, nobody, nobody but Jesus," and it's from my song, Run With The Horses. So, yeah, you got to get that one, because I love Run With The Horses. I was made to... I almost sang it for you guys. All right, so I love you guys. I will be at Mega. And you can go register for Mega, which is actually free to go unless you want to register. There's premium registration available. And you can go to RyanLestrange.com to do that. And I will be there next Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So get there. It's going to be amazing. Thank you for putting up my website. I love all of you guys. You guys are awesome. If you have a prayer request, put it down there. I will pray for you. You can guarantee that I will pray for you, because I love you and I believe that God wants to touch you. And I know that tonight many have received peace in their sleep. If you receive peace in your sleep, don't be afraid to write me and message me and share your testimony. I love you guys so, so much. Yes, I get to hug you. I'm excited. And yes, God is healing you. So have an awesome night. I love you. Bye.